Welcome to the Valley View School District staff COVID-19 protocol reminder. Let's start with face coverings.
Are masks required? Can I take off my mask while at work? Does the mask need to cover my nose and mouth?
Yes, masks are required while on the Valley View properties and need to cover your nose and mouth. You may remove your mask if you are in a room by yourself or if you go outside, as long as you maintain 6-foot distancing from other people. Let's review COVID-19 symptoms and how they relate to reporting to work. The symptoms of COVID-19 are listed here and include shortness of breath, new congestion or runny nose, new cough, new loss of taste or smell, sore throat, fever over 100.4 degrees, fatigue from an unknown cause, muscle or body aches, nausea, new onset of severe or moderate headache and vomiting, diarrhea or abdominal pain from an unknown cause. A new onset of a symptom is not attributed to allergies or a pre-existing condition.
What if I wake up in the morning and I have one or more of the COVID symptoms? Should I still come into work?
If you have any COVID-like symptoms, do not report to on-site work. Stay home and notify your supervisor. If you start developing COVID-like symptoms while at work on site, immediately report to your supervisor or the building nurse. This is guidance from the Illinois Department of Public Health and the Centers for Disease Control.
What if I am waiting for COVID-19 test results, or I live with someone waiting for COVID-19 test results?
Do not report on site and notify your supervisor for next steps.
What if I come in close contact with someone who tests positive for COVID-19? And what is considered close contact?
Close contact is spending 15 minutes or more over the course of a 24-hour period at a distance of less than 6 feet with a person who tests positive for COVID-19. This includes providing care to someone who is sick with COVID-19, having direct physical contact with someone with COVID, sharing eating or drinking utensils with someone with COVID, or someone with COVID sneezed, coughed, or somehow got respiratory droplets on you.
If I have been in direct contact with someone who tests positive for COVID-19, what should I do?
Contact your supervisor and quarantine for 10 days from the start of the last contact with the person who tested positive for COVID-19. Your supervisor will provide you with guidance for submitting leave through human resources.
Do I have to quarantine for 10 days? What if I do not develop symptoms?
If you do not develop symptoms, your quarantine can end after day 10, or a negative test on day 6 can end the quarantine after 7 days. This is guidance from IDPH and CDC.
What if I test positive for COVID-19? What should I do?
Do not report to on-site work. Make sure to notify your supervisor immediately. You will need to isolate at home for at least 10 days from the onset of symptoms or the date on which you had the COVID test done if you do not have symptoms. This is guidance from IDPH and CDC.
If I tested positive for COVID and I isolated for 10 days, when can I return to work?
If you are off work for more than 3 days, you must submit a note from your healthcare provider, be fever-free for 24 hours without taking fever-reducing medication, and confirm with your supervisor that your symptoms have improved.
What should I do if I have COVID-like symptoms?
Notify your supervisor and contact your healthcare provider. This is guidance from IDPH and CDC.
If I have COVID-like symptoms, but I was not diagnosed with COVID, when can I return to work?
Submit a note from a healthcare provider documenting the alternative diagnosis or provide a negative COVID test result and be fever-free for 24 hours without the use of fever-reducing medication and have no nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea for 24 hours. Per VVSD protocol, a note from a healthcare provider for any sick leave which exceeds 3 consecutive days.
If I live with someone who is being evaluated for COVID, when can I return to work on site?
Quarantine at home until an alternative diagnosis is made or a negative COVID test result from that individual is received.
What if one of my household members is quarantining? Do I have to quarantine?
No. Contacts of contacts do not need to quarantine, but monitor yourself for symptoms of COVID, and if you become symptomatic, isolate, contact your supervisor and your healthcare provider.
How do I report my COVID-related isolation or quarantine absences if I use ASOP?
If you are an employee who reports an absence into ASOP and you are reporting an absence for a COVID-related reason, you will now have two options from which to select to report. If you are reporting for a COVID-related reason, whether you are isolating or quarantining and you are unavailable for work, you will need to select COVID QA quarantine absent. For those who need guest teachers, guest secretaries, etc., this will trigger a call out for coverage if needed and alert your building supervisor that you have a COVID-related concern. You should expect follow-up from your building department supervisor. If you are reporting for a COVID-related reason, whether you're isolating or quarantining, but you are available for work, for example, you have been authorized to work remotely, you will be able to select the COVID QP quarantine present absence reason. This will also trigger a call out for coverage if needed and alert your building supervisor that you have a COVID-related concern. It requires authorization from your building supervisor for use, and you should expect follow-up from them. All other absence codes and reasons are in effect and remain unchanged. In other words, sick days or personal days that are unrelated to COVID should just be coded as sick or personal days.
How do I report my COVID-related isolation or quarantine if I use Kronos?
Employees using Kronos, lunchroom playground aides, transportation staff, maintenance staff, nutrition services staff, should continue to follow their current reporting procedures. When calling in, you must let your supervisor know that your absence is COVID-related.
What should I do if I have more questions?
You can contact your supervisor or the building nurse. Refer to the staff guidance for COVID-19 on the Human Resources webpage. Click on the Return Together 365 link on the VVSD website and review the information on the IDPH or the CDC websites, or you can contact your healthcare provider. Thank you for your time, and remember, we are in this together.